In this video, we're going to practice finding the local extrema of a function. So we want to see if this function has any local maximums or minimums, and if so, what those values are. So here's our function, and actually this is if you completed the guided example earlier in this lesson, you've already worked with this function a little bit. So the function is f of x equals 3x cubed plus 4.5x squared plus 7. So we want to find any local maximums or minimums. Okay, so how do we start? So in general, a local maximum or minimum value can only occur at a critical point of the function. Now, not every critical point is going to be a local max or min, but if there is a local max or min, it's going to happen at a critical point. So the first thing we want to do is find those critical points. And of course, to do that, we have to take the derivative. So we're going to start by taking the derivative of this function. So this is a nice, simple, friendly polynomial. So if I take the derivative here, if I bring down that 3, that's going to give me a 9x squared plus, bring down the 2 is going to give me 9x, and then plus 0. So just 9x squared plus 9x. Okay, so we have our derivative. Let's find the critical points. So remember, the critical points are the points where the derivative either equals 0 or does not exist. So first let's think about if there's any points where the derivative does not exist. So our derivative in this case is a quadratic, 9x squared plus 9x. So that is defined for any x's, for any x value. So there are no points where the derivative does not exist. So we can move on to finding places where the derivative equals 0. So to do that, I need to solve the equation 0 equals 9x squared plus 9x. So to solve this, it's very helpful to factor on the right-hand side. So I can pull out a 9x, and I'm left with x plus 1. And then I would just set each factor equal to 0. So I get solutions of x equals 0 and x equals negative 1. And with your critical points, you always just want to check that they are in the domain of your original function. But my original function is just a polynomial, so these are in its domain because its domain is all real numbers. Okay, so I have my two critical points. So these critical points are possible extrema of the function, but at this point I still don't know. So I'm going to proceed with the same steps as I would to find the intervals of increase and decrease of the function. So basically what I want to do is I want to divide the real number line into chunks based on my critical points. And often people do that with the help of sort of a number line chart that looks something like this. Okay, so the important points on my number line are negative 1 and 0. My critical points. So I am going to label them here. And you can see this sort of divides up the number line into, in this case, three segments. And those critical points are places where the sign of the derivative could change. And like I would if I were trying to find the intervals of increase or decrease, I want to test each of these chunks or each of these intervals to see if the derivative is positive or negative in that interval. Okay, so let me show you what I mean. So my first interval I'm looking at is here. Okay, so this is kind of the first chunk I'm looking at, values that are less than negative 1. So I want to determine if the derivative is positive or negative on that interval. So how do I do that? Well, all I have to do is pick a test point, any test point in that interval, and plug it into the derivative. So let's say I want to test f of negative 2. And I don't even really need, I don't need to know exactly what the value of the derivative is, I just need to know if it's positive or negative. So if I use my factored form, so remember the factored form of my derivative was 9x times x plus 1, kind of the shortcut is just to think about what's the sign of each of those factors. So for negative 2, 9x would be negative, and x plus 1 would be negative, so that's a positive overall. So my derivative is positive on that interval. Okay, And then we can move on to our next interval, which is numbers between negative 1 and 0. So once again, I can just pick a test point. And let's see, I pick negative 1 half. Sorry, this should be f prime of negative 2 and f prime of negative 1 half. And once again, I'm just going to check the sign of each of the factors. So let's see, 9x would be negative, but x plus 1 now would be positive. Negative 1 half plus 1 is a positive number. So this is negative overall. So my derivative is negative on that interval. And then I just have one more interval to check. 0 and or greater than 0. So let's try f prime of 1. Let's see if that's positive or negative. So 9x, that's going to give me positive, and x plus 1 is going to give me positive. So this is a positive overall. Okay, so far our steps have been exactly identical to the steps we used to determine if a function was increasing or decreasing. So if that was what you were asked at this point, you could just read off your chart, right? So where the derivative is positive, if I want to add an extra layer to my chart here, where the derivative is positive, the original function is increasing. And where the derivative is negative, the original function is decreasing. So we have a function that's increasing, and then at negative 1 it changes to decreasing, and then at 0 it changes to increasing again. So you could write down those intervals if you needed to, but here what we're concerned with is where the function may have a maximum or minimum. So remember what the first derivative test tells us. The first derivative test tells us that if at a critical value, the function changes from increasing to decreasing, we have a local max there. And that kind of makes sense, right? So if I kind of picture in my mind my function's increasing and then it's decreasing, it makes sense that there would be a local maximum at that critical point. So in this case, then, we see that we have a local maximum at x equals negative 1. And then the other part of, or one of the other parts of the first derivative test says that if at a critical point we change from decreasing to increasing, then that critical point is a local minimum. And that makes sense too, right? If I change from decreasing to increasing, then I'm going to have a local minimum point. Okay, so I have both a local max and a local min here. Okay, so let's record our answers. Local max and local min. So we want to be a little bit careful about the way we report our answer. So what the function is asking is, and this wording here is maybe a little ambiguous, but find the local maxima and minima. So it's actually asking for the local max and min values. So kind of a good way to report that is to write it as f of negative 1, because then you're telling where it is, equals, but then actually report that function value. So f of negative 1, you want to remember to plug those into the original function. So this is going to be 3 times negative 1 cubed plus 4.5 negative 1 squared plus 7, which if you work that out gives you 8.5. So f of negative 1 equals 8.5 is our local max. And then with the local min, well, that was at x equals 0, but what's the actual minimum value? That would be f of 0 equals 3 times 0 cubed plus 4.5 times 0 squared plus 7. So that would be f of 0 equals 7. All right, so these are our local maximum and local minimum values. And in this case, we just had one of each, but you can have more than that. And one more important thing to note, we didn't see this in this example, but in theory, you could have, let's see, we have a critical point C, and it doesn't change signs. That's something that could happen. And in that case, that critical value would not be a local max or min. So one thing that you can always do to check yourself is just quickly look at the graph. So I already have that ready for us. So we said that there should be a local max at x equals negative 1. with a value of 8.5, and that looks good from here. And then a local min at 0, 7. Looks good as well. So these are the steps you follow to find local maxima and minima.